So for a few minutes, I'm just going to share some thoughts about perspective. To give some context, I'm in the valley in Ennerdale and the River Lyser is flowing past me. The clouds are shifting over the hills. It's looking wonderful. So perspective, where to start? You'll find in the toolkits a lot of different video material and still photographs. Some of them taken of very, very tiny details and some of the much broader landscape. It's the macro and the micro. So how you want to play with this in your writing is up to you. You might want to really stick with a very small detail, or you might want to look at the overview. And in a way, that kind of mirrors what's going on here in Ennerdale, where it's a landscape scale of change and allowing natural processes to find their way. But that might be as simple as lichen on a wall or as grand as how the forest is spreading over the hills. So I think, as I say, it's always hard to teach writing, but what I can suggest is some exercises to try things out. So if you think about a big view and you look right into the distance at the clouds, perhaps, without really thinking too much, just write down three or four words that brings to mind. Very distant. And then bring your frame of focus a bit closer to the hills and choose some words to describe that. Then you can draw in even closer to, perhaps in this case, the wall, the built landscape. Choose a few words to describe that, and there you've got the human lived heritage. This used to be walled in order to keep sheep in for grazing patterns. Now the valley, at least here, is given over to cattle and they're not hemmed in by gates and walls. So the walls are beginning to tumble and they're telling their own story. So then you kind of come in closer and I've been really mesmerised by the tiny drops of dew that are in the grass today, and they're catching the light, little tiny globes. And then you can bring the perspective even closer into yourself. So how do you feel with your external senses? Just a few words on that. And then even closer into the emotional world. So that's one suggestion of changing perspectives. Another one is to do with time. And again, I've just talked about the wall. How much time does it take to make a wall like this and clear a field for grazing? How long does that wall stand? How many lives have been invested, human lives, in keeping that wall going? And now it's passing. There's been archaeological digs here. The valley has been settled since before Mesolithic times. That's a big time scale, but it's tiny compared to the time scale of glaciation. So play with that. Play with that perspective. I think time and place are the key elements there. The other perspective, of course, is whose perspective are you writing from? Is it I, which is the first person, your experience? And that, in a piece of writing, really helps the reader to identify with an experience of being in place, because they can begin to feel it through you. You might want to write in third person and tell a story, a historical story of somebody else who was here, or you want to imagine their story. And then the other perspective is of the environment and the natural processes. And this is incredibly difficult if you want to write from the perspective of a tree or a wall. How might you do that? There are resources in our packs, different pieces of writing that perhaps don't write so much from the perspective of natural things. And when I said wall, I mean stones. But they manage to bring their voice in, or at least include their presence in the story of a place. So just to finish off, I thought I'd read something about presence. My writing, I always seem to come back to writing in the present moment, because I find that the most powerful for me. I'm not a historian, I just like to dwell in the present. So this inspired me. It's by John Fowles, who wrote a book called The Tree. It's a very small book, but full of inspiration. And he's one for trusting the present. He says, "We lack trust in the present, this moment, this actual seeing, because our culture tells us to trust only the reported back, the publicly framed, the edited, the thing set in the clearly artistic or the clearly scientific angle or perspective. One of the deepest lessons we have to learn is that nature, of its nature, resists this. It waits to be seen otherwise in its individual presentness and from our individual presentness. And I like that perspective, not just in the context of writing that kind of real, vibrant, present moment, but also in the context of Ennerdale, in capturing both its history, but also what's going on from moment to moment. And that kind of underpins the concept behind wilding this place and perhaps other places, is to allow each moment to unfold as the natural process inclines it to, and in line with the human lives that are working there and farming the area or tending it in whatever way seems appropriate for that particular place. So enjoy the resources, and I hope that's helped a bit about perspective.